Hi there, I am Dhruvo, and in this video I am going to talk about few advanced features of Java, specifically Java version 8 and beyond. I have been playing with Java for last 18-20 years now and have experience working in Java based complex enterprise application and still continuing with this. During this journey I have observed that significant number of developers still do not truly use advanced features which are available since Java version 8. Today is 26 November 2018, although Java 8 was launched in back March 2014. It is a quite a long time. I encourage all Java developers to use advanced features more. Hence, I want to discuss what are those advanced features and how you can leverage them. I will demonstrate using hands-on coding so you may find the discussion more interesting going forward. I may not cover everything, all the new features, but here is a list of items that you may want to be aware of. So first, functional style of programming, which is introduced in Java version 8 and definitely gives you more flexibility to write cleaner code or lesser code, and also gives you opportunity to write efficient and readable code. So I'll definitely demonstrate how to use or write functional style of programming going forward when we will do the hands-on workshop. Second is distributed processing using stream. If you know about parallel stream API, that will definitely help writing distributed system. There are other features like module, jailing, JShell. So these are introduced in Java 9 and definitely you should know about this. Reactive stream, JavaFX, Graal VM, these are more advanced features and introduced in latter version of Java. And hopefully I definitely expect you to explore these keyword in Google and try to find more information from internet and learn about this. It will definitely help you going forward. In this video, I will mostly focus on functional style of programming, how to write it, and stream APIs. We'll start with writing functional interface. I'll demonstrate how to write functional interface and how you can use it in from your code. We'll discuss about predicate interface, and there are different other functional interface available by default that you can also leverage. And definitely I will show you how to write and use lambda expression. I'll give you multiple examples writing lambda expression. We'll also talk about method reference and how you can use it in your code. And definitely there will be multiple examples. I'll demonstrate about different examples, how to use stream APIs, how those new APIs can help you to write more efficient program. And we will also quickly go through dead time APIs. Okay, so let's not waste more time. So let's jump into your comfortable IDE, whatever you want to use, that is fine. But as a prerequisite, I would expect you should have basic to intermediate Java programming knowledge, familiarity with any IDE. I mostly use VS Code or STS. Maybe I'll use STS, but you can use Eclipse, IntelliJ, whatever IDE you are comfortable with, that is fine. And if you have basic knowledge of working and setting up a Java environment in your local system and how you can compile, run, how you can write different codes, how you can explore APIs through command prompt, so that will definitely help. But any IDE should be sufficient. Okay guys, if I continue with the hands-on experience in this video, so definitely video length will increase. So I'll request you to watch the next video in this series. Thank you. And if you like this video, please subscribe this channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon.